think when I came in, we tried to turn them loose and let them go. We tried to give them some fits where we wanted them fit and play fast. And that takes a little bit of pressure off of you. Hey, if I get my fit, and it showed that it worked. But I think I do think the experience of it. Obviously, Tiny's new, so it's been a transition getting him in with those guys. I think they're playing better just because they've seen more game time. And the other reason I think now is that they've got confidence. And you know, you can't play the game if you're not confident. You just can't do it. And now all of a sudden, whether they can or whether they can't, they believe they can. So that's a big, big part of it. And that was a hard thing to get done.
When you walked in your first day on the job and looked at the group you had, did you feel like there was the potential there to be a really solid group if everything came together?
Well, I took the job because of the players in that room. And, you know, I had a contract where I didn't have to go to work. One, I wanted to come to Tennessee, and two, I knew who I was coming to Tennessee with Chaney and with them guys in that room. So I knew they were really good players and just for whatever reason hadn't gelled yet. But I certainly had recruited a lot of those guys, lost out in the recruiting battle on a lot of those guys. So I knew they were good players, and that's why I wanted to be a part of it.
I hope I
answered your question.
Yeah, that was right. The skill position, sometimes you can plug in a younger guy immediately, a receiver or something, but offensive line, it seems like it really takes some years of seasoning to get where you want to be. Is that the case that a lot of these guys were thrown in at a pretty young age?
I think it's exactly the case. You know, I think we've got three or four starters that started 2 years ago, and they're still here, you know, and they'll still be here next year, some of them. So, yeah, I think it's a big deal. And it was very similar at North Carolina where we had to play some younger guys, and I think they're probably playing pretty well right now, too. So the experience part of it's a huge deal with it. And again, I think we're only losing one of the starters, you know, next year. And of course, Marcus Jackson's played a lot of ball, played 29 snaps. Alex Bullard played a lot of ball this year. So there's seven guys that's played a lot of football for us.
How beneficial is it to rotate seven guys instead of five?
I think it helped us a bunch on Saturday. I really do. You know, it was hot. It was 85 snaps. We were able to get Marcus in there. And of course, Bullard's been playing the heavy tight ends, you know. And he played tackle the week before. But I just think it's really helped us stay fresher, and it's going to help us in the future. If we ever have an injury or anything of that nature, it's going to be good for us. And obviously, we'd like to get to eight if we could, get another one involved in that if we can. But obviously, the number one thing is that we got the right people on the field to win.
Sam, what's the focus for your group this week?
Well, we just have to get better, and we have to, you know, this week our focus is we're trying to get better at the inside zone, at the tight zone, and we're trying to eliminate all pre-snap penalties, and that's our goal for this week.
With the line coming off such a good game, would you rather play this week than have a week off?
I think so. I mean, because we're healthy. You know, if we weren't healthy, it'd be a different story. But we'll be ready when it's time to be ready. But you know, when you're rolling a little bit, you like to keep playing. But we've got things to work on, and so we've put a big concentration on a certain pass protection and two certain runs that we need to get better at. And so we put a big emphasis this week to getting that done.
How much does success begin success?
Bunch, a lot. You know that it really does, and what it does, it just brings confidence. And you can only beat somebody so much, and eventually he's going to get up and try to fight you back. And I think that's a little bit what's happening with us right now.